warm-up team. Yeah! Yeah! Nothing like average performance to get us going for the rest of the evening, am I right? All right, well, I tell you what, I was planning on singing, but you guys kind of stole my thunder on that one, so let me bring out what I had in mind. You know, I figured if the Cumberland Valley Chord Factory was going to entertain us with song, which is so overdone, right? I'd give us something a little bit different. So let me start with something that, as a pastor, I know how to do really well. We're taking a collection for the Cumberland Chord Valley Factory this evening, and I'm going to pass these around, and I am serious about this. I'm going to pass these around, and if you have any, come on, they were okay. Nickels and dimes, right? All right, nickels and dimes, but go ahead and support our guests for joining us this evening. Thank you guys very much, seriously. You guys were wonderful. But I got something better. If they're doing music, then I'm going to bring you athletic ability with my awesome sports prowess. So I brought some equipment here. Let me just... All right. Hold on.
Put this down. Okay. All right.
All right. What are you doing?
I was going to... Rob Duncan, I have... This is a... Me and my basketball... Go way back. I can tell you, I won't even bring up the tennis racket because I know you are nothing about that.
Is it basketball?
Yeah, watch. I got skills.
You got any tricks or something?
Yeah, let me show you.
Maybe I just can't do it.
No, hold on. Let me just... I'm going to go between the legs. I can take you in basketball round. But I have tricks. I have tricks. You guys ready? Let me try again. I play.
Let's see you do that.
Fine.
Wait, this equipment's expensive. Come on.
Seriously.
Okay,
go. Just between the legs. Between the legs. Can you do that? Can you go between the legs?
With soccer
ball. With the basket. Soccer basketball, Rob Duncan.
Between the legs.
Yeah. Let's. Can you dribble it between your legs? You know what? I decided I've actually.
Oh, coming down to your left.
No.
Some athletics to help. I mean, you got Megan here with the Fellowship of Christian Athletes. I'm helping out with Fellowship of Christian Athletes. And now you're talking tennis?
Yeah. I mean, I could Sampras this.
You know, I want some advice on that. Maybe you could find someone that, I don't know, coaches a tennis team. Maybe, you know, county champions last night, mixed doubles. Boys
doubles. County champions. All right, you know what? You take your sports stuff.
You know, just
lucky this is Saturday night, not Sunday morning. I've got something better. Because the truth is, I haven't done sports in a long time. But I do know my academics. After all, later this year, everyone in this room will have to refer to me as the Reverend Dr. Kyle Durbin. And so, I've prepared a bit of prose that I've been working on to demonstrate my academic prowess. Ladies and gentlemen, for my next performance, allow me to read you a short portion of my manuscript that I've been working on. Completely original. It was dark.
too dark. The persistent pastor playfully poked and prodded his preferred perniciousness. Can God create a boulder that God can't lift? The question nagged at his soul, like one of Megyn Kelly's ex-kids demanding their peanut butter and jelly sandwiches with great expectations.
Pastor Kyle, wait. I'm sorry, I have to interrupt you for a second. What is that you're reading there? Is that a novel?
Yeah, I'm working on it. I think I really kind of like landed on what it is to be a Christian pastor.
So you're a novelist now, right?
Yeah, definitely. I'm gonna publish this.
Yeah.
I think it was pretty perfect prose.
That's one way to think about it.
Yeah.
Maybe like a few pointers.
Well, I mean, who are you to tell me? I mean, I see you have a lot of books there, but so you read a lot, Brad?
Yeah, I read a lot, but see, I wrote all these books, right? I wrote and published all these books, and like every professional writer, I carry these around with me everywhere. In fact, they had dinner with me tonight.
I saw them. I thought you were behind. In grading your paperwork.
So I, if you would like a few pointers, I'd be happy.
You know what? Sure. What do you got for me?
Let me take a look at your.
Okay, it's basically perfect as is.
Well, I do have one tiny little critique.
Sure. Okay.
It's terrible. there's no scene. There's no character.
It was a dark scene.
There's no development. There's no tension. There's no comment. But you do have a day job, right, that you can fall back on.
Not tomorrow. Jay's preaching for me.
One positive, though, I would like to mention. The letter P nailed it.
I did that on purpose.
Yeah.
Yeah, because pastor.
Yeah.
Because I think everything should just an alliteration off of my title.
Well, I tell you what, if you work on the other letters as much as you work on the letter P, I think you'll have it and do the other stuff that I told you about, and maybe, you know, one day, you know, maybe this will be you.
You know what? I was just in the kitchen and it was dirty. And maybe as a United Methodist man, you should just like go, I think they need your help. But I do appreciate it. I appreciate it.
Give it up for Brad Barkley, our resident scholar.
Don't forget it. Can't do academics. Can't do sports. I'm just going to do something recreational, because that's something that men are good at. I'm going to teach everyone here a little bit about a hobby that I've taken up recently with my son, fishing. So, let me see exactly what the script says about that. I'm going to go ahead and get started with my fishing right now.
Whoa, everyone.
Hi, Terry.
I'm sorry, but what you doing? I see you fish. Well, I see you put a line in the water.
I mean, I take on the Yeah, I know. I take Harrison fishing all the time. And just because he catches the fish and I watch him catch the fish doesn't make him a better fisherman.
How many fish have you
caught? You know, Terry, it's not about the number of fish you catch. It's about the leisure activity of sitting on the water with God and creation.
Well, buddy, that's what we tell people who can't fish and make them feel good.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'll grab my fishing rod, you grab your fishing rod, and let's see if we can make something happen here.
Okay, alright.
Good luck, Terry, because this guy right here, hook, line, sinker. It's not the size of the fishing rod that matters, Terry. How do you?
Oh, goodness gracious.
Last year, real quick, and we all came up with kids fishing, right? Every child caught a fish. Every adult fish caught a fish.
So I'm going to sing Love Me Tender by Elvis Presley. And you already sang, Bill, you already sang.
I saw a great big wooden mark floating in
the air. No, I really thought.
I picked it up and opened it up and went to my surprise. Well, I discovered a right before.
Do you want to see Elvis?
Do you remember that song?
Oh, I remember it.
What's it called?
It's called that song that you sang to interrupt me while I was going to sing Love Me Tender.
That's called My Thing, 1956, Bill Harris.
Back when I was, you know.
Remember Jeff? Jeff. Hey, did I tell you I recently retired? I retired.
From what?
From work.
You did?
Yeah.
Okay, so tell me about it.
Well, I retired and I couldn't stop working, so I went to school.
Okay.
I went to Walmart Institute.
Yeah, how'd that work for you?
Well, Walmart Institute, where I studied for 6 months and got my little red jacket.
Okay.
And how to be a greeter. Graduated with honor. I did.
I graduated somewhere recently.
First day on the job?
Yeah.
Fired.
Why did you get fired, Bill?
Lady came into the store and I said something to her that she didn't like and they fired me. I'll tell you the rest of the story at next week's confession.
Okay.
can I tell a story?
You know what? At this point, why not? Can Bill tell a story?
Sure!
Yeah!
This is a story about Billy Graham. You know who Billy Graham was?
I heard of him once or twice.
Yeah, it's really important that you understand who Billy Graham was. This one will work.
Yeah,
Graham
crackers?
Yeah, but the other one.
Oh, Billy Graham!
Billy Graham.
I got it, the evangelist.
Yeah,
I know. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Billy the evangelist.
Good, we got it.
Well, Billy was in this little town one time. He was planning a one of his religious, you know, evangelistic things. And this is when he was pretty young. And he was driving down the street of this little town and he saw a young fellow, like Garrett, walking along the street, and he stopped and he said, hey, young fella, he said, do you know where the post office is? The young fella said, yeah. He said, you turn around, go down to the second light, turn right, turn left, and it's on the corner. He said, well, thank you there. Young lad, he said, are you coming to the meeting tonight? He said, it's going to be a great meeting, and I'm going to show you how to go to heaven. Show you your way to heaven.
Sounds like Billy Graham.
And young Paul said, no, I'm not going. Well, why aren't you going? He says, I'm going to show you how to get to heaven. He
said, "Well, sir," he said, "I don't know how you're going to show me to get to heaven. You didn't even go to the post office." did we come up here, sir?
Yeah, hey, let's sing a song. If you know these words, sing along with Bill. But I'll tell you what, there's not a better Elvis in our room this evening.
So. Well, we're pretty harsh, you know. We're cleaning up in the kitchen. Tender, love me true, never let me go. Or did you? What are you doing? You forget the words.
Yeah, you got the words right there.
Yeah, but I can't read them until I put them on the class.
Oh, let's go.
Love me tender, love me true, all my dreams fulfill. For my darling, I love you, and I love you so.
So the next line is love me tender, love me long, and we'll say,
love me tender, love me long. It's there where I belong, and we'll never part. Love me tender, love me true, all my dreams fulfill. For my darling, I love. And I always will.
Last verse is love me tender. I'm just going to let Bill take this, and this is for all the ladies.
Love me tender, love me dear, tell me you are mine.
From his heart, you can tell.
I'll be yours through all the years, till end of time.
And we'll sing love me tender.
Love me tender, love me true, all my dreams fulfill. For my darling, I love you, and I always will.
For my darling.
For my darling, I love you, and I always will.
Alright, well, at this point, let's be honest, I have no idea what the heck I'm supposed to do, because I thought the one thing that I did on Sunday mornings I could do. I don't even have a script anymore. Somebody threw it on the ground, and I'm kind of at a loss. So
wait a minute.
Can I help you? Who are you? She didn't have a beard.
first of all, you didn't have any women involved. You kept giving all the credit to the men.
I mean, okay, you might have a point there with not having women involved, but I mean, I think our guys did a good job tonight.
Well, yeah, but you forgot the most important thing that you could have done to make your performance even better.
Oh, okay, Mom. How could I have made my performance better this evening?
You didn't ask your mother for her help.
Oh, I had to ask my mom for help. That makes a lot of sense. You know what? You might have had a point there. I've really gotten where I am today because of my mom being such an incredible mother. Do you have any other advice?
Well, instead of trying to do all of this all by yourself, why don't you bring all of these talented men out here to do something? Together, boys! Come on up here and let's show the ladies what we have to offer.
Okay, men? With no rehearsal whatsoever, can you come up here right now? We have to entertain the ladies. It's Mother's Day, and I need any men that are willing to come on stage.
Come on, son!
You know what? Guys, I know we're all up here, but I have no idea what we're supposed to do. Dave, do you have an idea?
Yeah, we'll take it from here.
Okay. Let's can we huddle? Can we we're good? Love you, and we say thank you. So this song is for you.